Again in a lesson video from Make a Wish, and this is Teacher Sunny with Secondary 1, lesson number 7. Today we will start on the new topic about exponents, operations of exponents. Now, it's all about power. So, what about that? What is power in math? Actually, it's called exponents. One more time, exponents. This is the form here. X to the power of n. Alright, so let's see what is the meaning of exponents. Here, a will be your base number and n will be your exponent of the power. Okay, power of a, power of the base. It will be the index for the base. Now, the concept will be if a is any whole number and a to the power of n equals a times a times a times itself, right? Times itself together, how many times? Depends on the power, depend on n. So, times itself together, n times. Let's see, a to the power of n means a times itself, n times. And you can read as a to the power of n or a to the nth power. So this one will be the ordinal number here with th, did you see? Here. Alright, so it's just like first, second, third, right? Fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and ninth, and tenth with th, see? Alright, or you can read as a to the power of n here. Alright, now let's see more examples on exponents, okay? Let's start from Iron Man. What is this called? 4 to the power of 5. Very good. What is the base number? Number 4. And what is the exponent? Number 5. Very good. Or power. Alright, so it means 4 times itself 5 times equals 1024. Alright, next. What is this called? 2 to the power of 9. Very good. What is the exponent then? Number 9. Very good. Exponent of power. Now it means 2 times itself 9 times. Right? Equals 512. Next one. What about this? What is the base number? Negative 25, very good. So what is this called? Negative 25 to the power of 2. Nice. And that means negative 25 times itself 2 times, right? Equals positive or negative answer. Negative times negative equals, very good, positive. So the answer will be 625. All right. Moving on, this is called negative 10 to the power of 3. So, negative 10 times itself 3 times, right? And this one, because it's 3 times, so the answer will be negative, okay? Negative, so the answer will be negative 1000. All right, two more examples. What is this called? What? Huh? Yes! 3 to the power of 7. 3 to the power of 7. And that means 3 times itself 7 times. Very good. Equals 2187. Alright, last one. Last example. What is this? What is the base number? 0. Very good. What is the exponent? 4. Very good. And this is called 0 to the power of 4. What does it mean? It means 0 times itself, how many times? 4 times. But 0 times together is actually equal 0. Alright, very good. So far so good. Now, let's see. Did you know about this? 6 to the power of 2 is actually, can call it 6 square. See? 6 square is come from 2D, alright? The shape is square, so it's called 6 square. So sine times sine, same, right? It's equal. So 6 times itself, 2 times, or 6 square. Next, what about this? 8 to the power of 3, or it's called 8 cube. Cube. Here, this is a picture of cube 3D. So you have width, time, length, time, height, which is the same. So same time itself together. How many times? 3 times. Very good. So it's called cubed. All right. It is a nickname for power of 2 and power of 3. All right. Let's see more example. What is this called? 2 to the power of 3. Yes. But I want you to use their nickname. Okay. 2 cubed. Very good. And 8 squared. And then 5 squared. And last one, 11 cubed. Okay, very good. So don't forget, you can use nickname. It will be easier, shorter, all right? Next, negative exponent. Now let's see, this is negative exponent. So negative on the power. What does it mean? It actually means 1 divided by that exponent, okay? You pull it down. So it's called the inverse exponent, all right? Or the reciprocal of negative exponent. All right, the concept will be A is any whole number again, but this time 1 will divide it by the base number n times, all right? Divided by A times together, n times. See, A to the power of negative n means 1 is divided by A. How many times? N times. All right, let's see. It can be read as A to the power of negative n. All right, don't forget, negative. Okay, now, what is this exponent? Let's see. From the first one, you have 2 times together, 3 times. So, what is this? 2 to the power of 3. Very good. Or 2 cubed. Don't forget to use the nickname, all right? Next. This is what? This is 1 divided by negative 2. 2 times, right? Or this time together. So it will be negative 2 to the power of negative 2. Very good. So this is negative number. Okay, oh, negative exponent. All right. It actually means 1 divided by negative 2 to the power of 2. But then you can move it up. It will be negative exponent, like so. All right, let's see. What about this? How many times of 3 that times together? Let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So that means 3 to the power of 7. Very nice. And next, how many times for 10? 10 will be the base number, right? As you know it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 10 to the power of 5. Nice. Let's go for Batman. Now this time, 1 divided by 5 times together 3 times. So the base will be 5. Very good. But you see 1 and then divided by the base number, that means negative exponents. Very nice. So 5 to the power of negative 3. All right. Next, let's see. Wow. This is negative 6. Negative 6 is your base number now. Time together, 3 times. So that means negative 6 cubed. All right, so far so good. Let's move on to the operations of exponents. Now, let's see. Operations in math has 4, all right? The basic 4. Plus, minus, times, and divide. Or addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. All right, the operations of exponents always follow the laws of exponents. So today you need to learn laws of exponents, which is 5. We will learn 5 laws of exponents today. First one is called exponent of 0, exponent of 1, multiplication of exponent, division of exponent, and negative exponent. All right, let's see. First one, exponent of 0. Very easy. Let's see. See, no battery, right? So that means 0 It's actually one. You're not dead yet. Just really sleepy. All right. It's like low battery. So A to the power of 0 equals 1. Always equals 1. All right. See? A cannot be 0. Okay? 0, if 0 is the base number, that exponent will be 0. All right? Cannot be 0. And this is 0 power. Now, let's see example. 5 to the power of 0. Again, always equals 1. So, 1. 10 to the power of 0 equals 1. 25 to the power of 0 equals 1. Very good. So, x sub 0 to the power of 0. That is 0, right? Any base number will be 1 if it has the power of 0. That's it. Exponent of 0. Or 0 power. Alright, moving on to exponent of 1. See? It's just like you're looking in the mirror. This is the identity power. Same for the base. So, a to the power of 1 equals a. So, you have the base number. Okay? Just answer the base number. Let's see example. 5 to the power of 1 equals 5. 10 to the power of 1 equals 10. And then, 25 to the power of 1 equals 25. Okay, so it is called identity power, or the same as the base, if you have the power of 1. Alright, or exponent of 1. Moving on to multiplication of exponent. So C, this is A to the power of M, times A to the power of N. Multiplication, you see, times, right? So it's actually equal plus. If you have time the base number together with the same base, like this, see, the power will be plus. All right, the power will plus together. See, times with same base is called product of powers. Product mean times. All right, but it's actually plus. Don't forget, if you have times together with the same base, the power will be plus together. Alright, let's see example. Now, 5 to the power of 2 times 5 to the power of 4. So it's actually same base, right? You need to check first if it's same base or not. Same, 5, number 5 will be the base number. And then the exponents will plus together. See, 2 plus 5 up, 2 plus 4. And then it will equals to 5 to the power of 6, right? So let's see the proof. Now, 5 to the power of 2, that means times together 2 times, and then 4 here is the power, right? So it times together, how many times? 4 times. So when you times together like so, you just count how many? How many base number that times together? 6, right? So it will be equal. So it's just easier for you to remember that to plus. Alright? Next, what about this? 2 to the power of 4 times 2 to the power of 3 equals? Same base, yes. And then plus the exponents together. 4 plus 3, right? Equals 2 to the power of 7. Nice! This is called multiplication of exponent, or the products of powers. Times equals plus for the power. Just like that. Next, division of exponent. Same concept, but you use division, right? Same base, and then you use division, and it will be minus. So the top part is minus to the bottom part. Don't switch, okay? M minus N cannot be N minus M. Please take note on this, okay? Minus or subtraction cannot be switched, remember? So on top will be the first number always. Now let's see, this is division of the same base. It's called the quotient of power. Quotient mean divide. All right, the answer of division, so you will use minus. Let's see examples. First one, 5 to the power of 7 divided by 5 to the power of 4, right? Or 5 to the power of 7 over 5 to the power of 4. Now, equals 5, same base, check first. And then, which one is the first number? 4 or 7? The top part, very good. So 7 first, 7 minus 4. Equal 5 to the power of 3. Right, let's see the proof. See, 5 times itself, 7 times on top, and then on the bottom, time itself, 4 times. And then, as you know it, you can cut, right? Cut, 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 cut 4 5s, and then you left with how many? 3. So 5 to the power of 3. There it is. Next example, let's see. 2 to the power of 12 over 2 to the power of 5. Now, same base, and then which one is the first number of the power? 12 or 5? 12, very good. So 12 minus 5. So equals 2 to the power of 7. Nice. Now, let's see. This is the last one. Last rules today. Negative exponent. You have learned it already. So it's like negative power pull you down. So a to the power of negative n equals 1 over a to the power of n. All right, so it will be 1 divided by a to the power of n. Pull it down or inverse power. All right, just move it down. Okay, under number 1 over here. And again, a cannot be 0 because if 1 divided by 0, it will be no answer, right? So a cannot be 0. All right, inverse power. Now let's see example. 5 to the power of negative 4. So inverse, pull it down, negative, pull it down. It will be 1 over 5 to the power of 4. Or let's see this. 3 to the power of 2 divided by 3 to the power of 3. So again, same base. So you can use minus, right? See, first number first and then minus with 3. So the answer will be 3 to the power of negative 1. Now negative power or negative exponent, you will inverse that power. So it will be 1 over 3 to the power of 1 or 1 over 3. Simple as that. All right, let's see the meaning of exponent review for the first time. Now, what is this? Which one is the base number? A or N? A, very good. And N is called exponent or power. All right, so that means A to the power of N equal A times itself. How many times? N times, very good. And A is any whole number, all right? Now let's see example. If I have number 27, how can I turn it into exponent? You need to find all the factors, all right? So let's see which two number times together equal 27, 9 and 3. So when you have 3, you stop, okay? Because 3 is a prime number already, so stop it, but let's put it into a smaller number. This is called factor. You need to find the factors of 9, okay? 9 is actually come from 3 times 3. Very good. So you hit 3. It's a prime number already. So that means 3 times 3 times 3 equals 27, right? See? Or 3 to the power of 3. Okay, this is how you find the exponent from the standard number or just normal number here. Okay, now let's go for the review on laws of exponents. First one, what is this? A to the power of 0 equals no battery, remember? No battery will be 1, very good. 0 power equals 1. And next, what about this? You have mirror. You look into yourself. Identity power or 1 power? A to the power of 1 equal base number. Very good. Same A. So identity power or the power of 1. Next. C. A to the power of M times A to the power of N equals, this is multiplications, right? same base, you plus, very good, you plus the power. So it will be a to the power of m plus n. It's called product of power. All right, next, what about this? A to the power of m divided by a to the power of n. This is actually same base, but division, right? Divide by a to the power of n here. So you use subtraction on the power. Okay, but which one is the first one? The top one or the bottom one? Top, very good. So a to the power of m minus n. Or it's called the quotient of powers. All right, quotient is the answer from division. Okay, last one. A to the power of negative n equals, again, negative pull you down, so it will be 1 over a to the power of n, or 1 divided by a to the power of n. This is called inverse power or negative power. All right, let's move on to example. Now, write the simplest exponential form. Simplest, that means you need to make sure that it's shorter version of this. This is long, right? For the question, it's really long. You need to try to make it smaller, shorter, simple, okay? Now, let's see, is it the same base? If you have the same base, you can smile, all right? It's easy to do, all right? Times together or divide? Times, right? So that means multiplication of the same base or products of power. Now, when you times, you will plus the exponent. See? You will plus together, but the base is the same. So first one will be 5, and then negative 8. Okay? Pull out the whole thing. Negative 8 is the exponent. So you use this. And next one, 9. Okay. Now, plus together. What is the answer? What is that? You have this, it will be negative 3, right? And then negative 3 plus 9 will be 6. Very good. 2 to the power of 6 is your answer. Now, therefore, 2 to the power of 5 times 2 to the power of negative 8 times 2 to the power of of 9 equals 2 to the power of 6. Next, let's see the next one. Now, if you have this, you can put it together first, like so, right? It's time together, same base. Again, smile and just plus together number 4 and number 5. So it will be 9. Very good. 3 to the power of 9 over 3 to the power of 12 over here. Now, next is division now, right? It's division or the quotient of power. So when you have this, you use plus or minus? Minus, very good. But which one is the first number? It's very important for minus. You cannot switch 9 or 12. You use the top part, very good. So it's number 9 minus number 12, like so. So it will be 3 to the power of 9 minus 12, negative, right? Yes, negative 3. So when you have negative power, what can you do? You inverse it, right? Inverse power or pull you down. It will be 1 over 3 to the power of 3. Okay, therefore, 3 to the power of 4 times 3 to the power of 5 over 3 to the power of 12 equals 1 over 3 to the power of 3. That's it, everyone. Now, it's your turn. Time for your worksheet, part 1. Part 1, you write the following expressions in the exponential form. Now, that means you need to put the base and the exponent, all right, in the form of base and exponent. Let's count. Just count the number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, base is number 2, 2 to the power of 5. Easy, huh? Next, let's see next one. What is the base number for number 1? Negative 9, very good. And how many times is times together? 5. So negative 9 to the power of 5. What about number 5 over here? 8.1 divided by the base number, so that means you have negative exponents, right? So it will be, what is the base number now? 1 or 10? 10, very good. So how many 10s together? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 10 to the power of negative 9. Alright, next part 2. What do you have to do? You need to find the value of the following exponents. First, see, 3 to the power of 3 equals 3 times itself 3 times, right? And you need to find the value also. So 3 times 3 equals 9. 9 times 3 equals 27. Very good. Now let's see one more example, alright? Let's see negative 4 to the power of 3. Here, what is the base number? Very good, negative 4. So that means negative 4 times itself 3 times. Now, what is the answer or the value of this negative or positive number? Negative, very good. So the answer is negative 64. Alright, now the rest is your turn. Let's move on to part 3 then. Part 3, you need to simplify the exponents. Now, make it the simple form. So that means make it shorter. Okay, so let's check first, is it the same base or not? If it yes, then very easy, you can do this. Alright, let's see, 3 times together, right? Base number is the same. So when you have multiplication, that means what? Plus, very good. So 3 to the power of 7, very good, 2 plus 5. Now next one, what about this? Do you have 2b? Times b to the power of 2 times b to the power of negative 4. Now 2, you don't need to change it. You just simplify b, right? Same base number. This one, b to the power of, it's not 0. If you have b here, that means the base, right? Power of 1. Don't forget, identity power or power of 1. This is b to the power of 1. Alright, if it no b at all, it will be power 0. So don't just discard this b. You need to count it as 1. Okay, so 1 plus 2 plus negative 4. Okay, so 1 plus 2 equal 3. 3 plus negative 4 equal negative 1. Very good. So 2 times b to the power of negative 1. But then negative power, you need to simplify this. It can be inverse, right? So it will be 2 divided by b, okay? Because b to the power of 1 pulled down to the negative power, from the negative power here. All right, let's see one more example. Let's go for number 7. First, what do you need to do? You can put it together, right? So first one, 1 plus negative 5. See, same base, but this is not 0, it's 1. So 1 plus negative 5 equals negative 4. Then you have both negative 4, right? For the power on top and in the bottom too. So minus, see, just like that, 2 minus equal plus, right? So it will be negative 4 plus 4. So it will be 3 to the power of 0 or 1 is your answer. Alright, 1 is your answer. Okay, so let's move on to last one, part 4. Part 4, you need to find the answer of the following expressions and color the picture from the color key. Over here, the key for your color. And this is the picture that you need to color, alright? Now, let's start from the first one. You have 2 to the power of 6 times 2 to the power of negative 2. Now, what you can do? You can plus, right? So it will be 2 to the power of 6 plus negative 4. It will be 2 to the power of 4 or 16. Remember, you need to find the answer. Alright, so let's see, where is 16? Here. See, it will be dark blue. So You need to find number one. Question number one. Okay? If you see number one, number one, number one, number one, all of number ones, you will need to color dark blue. Alright, so you find the rest of the answers and then you will find how to color it. Okay, that's it. That's all for today. So good luck with your answer. You need to use the laws of exponent. Okay, don't forget. And see you again next time. Bye bye.